excuse me,
athletic person call it dance background this season? Well, I studied martial arts before I did acting. So I would dance, and then I was started, like, oh, maybe I'll do stunts, like, before I was acting. So I trained a lot in martial arts, and dance background was ridiculously helpful. Especially in, like, movies, like, it's choreography, like, you're memorizing, it's like a dance with the other person. So it's, dance is really helpful. And I studied, like, Filipino martial arts, which they do a lot of stick work, which is, like, my bow staff and, like, the double sticks, so all the weapon stuff. A lot of training, and I like to do most of my training. Not all of them. Before I got on Arrow, like everything else I've ever done, I never had a stunt double. It was everything. And then I got an Arrow, and it was like, you have a stunt double. And there's certain things that I'm like, I don't want to do that. You're like jumping through a pane of glass. Like you'll get cut. Like there's certain things where it's like, it's not about just, it's, and there's so many variables, like they have to like press a button to shatter the glass, but they can't, you have to hit the glass first, because if they shatter it before you hit it, then the shot doesn't work. So they wait until you touch it, and then they shatter it, and it's like still glass, and you can still get cut. And so we need our stunt team to do some stuff.
How does Sarah deal with the
left off? What do you mean?
The last episode we saw was the ship took off.
Oh yeah, she's pissed. She's not gonna take it off. And I think, yeah, it was heartbroken too. They just left her. And we're there for a long time. I don't know if that details say how long we're there, but like we're there a long time, at least. So, and it's interesting how Sarah takes it and what she does.
Before Sarah died the first time, she was really fitting in really well with Team Arrow, and now you have this whole other team. How do you as the actress think of how you integrate your character on both teams? Like, what's the difference between those two teams?
Sarah's always kind of like a lone wolf, even like when she was with the team. I think it's hard for her sometimes with Team Arrow, because it's like, she's not somebody that's like with, where she doesn't like not being in charge. Not that she wants to be the leader, but like just people telling her what to do is like a no-go. And even now, I think with Rip, she has a hard time like if him being like, go do this, like, and like team, and everyone's calling him captain, and she's like, no. Like, they'll write it in, and like, I'm not calling him captain. Like, and things like, I've changed dialogue too, where like he would be like, so I need to know like that you're a part of the team now, like that you're here. And it's, instead of her being like, yeah, she's like, maybe, you know. I think that's a big part of Sarah, is like, she doesn't kind of, I don't know, except for like Ra's al Ghul, that's the only one that she's ever been like, okay, this is like the...
I really like the relationship that Cockrell and Wycomere has developed. Now, what do you tease about them coming over as they're, because they're helping each other still with their inner bloodlust.
Yeah, we see some of that for the next episode, which is nice. And I really hope that we get to explore it even more. And I hope their relationship, I think they're so different. Like, the characters are so different. But I hope that we can find a way to, like, really get that kind of same romance that Heatwave and Captain Cold have. I want, like, Sarah and Kendra to get that kind of deep friendship. So, but that's, like, got to be earned. So, see.
I find it really interesting that, you know, most traveling cruise shows have a rogue that finds a love interest at every stop, and I find it very interesting that Sarah is in that position, and also because of bisexuality, it's, and it could be anybody, basically. Like, can you talk a little bit about how different that is in a position, especially for a
This season has always never really been about love for Sarah, you know, like finding love, and I hope we get to play with that more. But that was fun. It was cool to do the 1950s thing, and it was like the perfect time for it. I really like that episode just because of all the like social issues that it kind of touched upon, with like the mixed marriage and like with, you know, Jack from the soda shop and like the jocks and like coming up to him because he's black, and Sarah being like a bisexual talking about, you know, like saying lesbian, and she's like, oh my god, it's like, it's not a bad word, like, it's okay. And it's just interesting how it was like that. I think there's a line when it's Stein is talking about like how idyllic it is and how amazing, and like Sarah and Jack's like, yeah, like, it's like, if you're white and like, yeah, and, you know, man and straight, like, it really wasn't that great for everybody else. So it's interesting. I like that we, I hope you do that more and more often. And like, it's such a weird show, like, just kind of out there in a good way, and I hope that we just kind of keep going a little weird.
For any time traveling show, I have to ask, what would be your favorite time period to go to, whether past or future?
I'd like to go to the 20s. I think that'd be pretty fun, the roaring 20s.
Any reason?
I don't know. I like the clothes. I like the, you know, like, everyone's like kind of, it's very eclectic. I'd go to like Berlin in the 1920s, like, when it was real eclectic art scene, you know, that was funny.
I like you got your stopwatch.
Yeah, it was out to
that's a hard one. I think it's interesting because it's like everybody goes on like one train of thought where it's like, oh, just go to college and then you get a good job so you can take care of your family. Like, that's security. That's what you want. And then it was like, don't do that because you should just follow your passion and do what you love and like don't worry about any of that. And now it's like changing. Now people are like, oh, turning, you know, like, that's not panning out either. I don't know. I guess follow the excitement, and that's what I always say. Like, follow the excitement. You do really only have one life, like. But it's also like, I have a friend who was talking to you. This is like the longest advice ever. But you know, like, it's cool to have a normal job too, and like do a 9-to-5, make good money, and then go home and not have to worry about work anymore, and that's good with your family. Like, that's cool too. Like, there is no, oh, like, you have to do something like spectacular. Like, find what works for you.